good evening to everyone. My hi to everyone. Audible enough? I don't know how many of you are baking along with me. Do we have people who are baking along? You just give me a thumbs up. So sorry, need to check the stuff. So I would like to know if people are there who are baking along with me today. Okay, so do you have your recipes ready? Sounds good? Okay, I cannot see the chat. I have my colleague with me who's checking the chat, who will in between keep on updating me if there are any queries. I'll begin here, okay? So we are gonna make apple pie. Everybody have recipes with them. What is apple pie? Apple pie is a kind of a pie which has apples as a main filling into it. Okay? So, as a pie, we are going to make a pie. We are going to make an apple filling which we are going to put into that. So, the recipe says apple hot pastry crust and the apple filling. Okay? And so, let's begin. First, we are going to make our pastry dough for which what we have here. Please let me know if you can see the ingredients. It's a flour, water, we have salt, we have butter, and this is cream, which is 20 grams of cream. This is the recipe, you know, you can take this as an egg yolk as well. Okay, so we are making eggless, so I have taken a cream, which is 20 grams. Okay, so let's start working on this. Flour, always sieve your flour. I have taken out the recipe. This is water. Okay. So when we say pie, okay, pies are supposed to be a savory. When we say apple pie, the crust, you will see there is no sugar in this recipe when we make a pastry crust. The reason is this apple pie, basically, it's a very comfort food. It is, if you look at the history back, it is from England in around 1400 years. They used to have this as a comfort food for them. So the pastry crust doesn't have a sugar in it. Apple, which has been cooked, has a bit of sugar by itself. We have our salt.
Chef, there is a query. Room temperature or cold water? Which one?
Water is a room temperature water because we are going to cook this. Okay? See, you will see that there is an equal amount of water and flour. I'll tell you why. So let's begin. Okay? I have my butter here, salt, and my cream here. Okay, I'm gonna use induction. Is this the feed? Okay. Can you all see the pot? Do you want me to get it closer to you guys? No, good enough. Okay. So pour your water first. Okay, I'm gonna add my butter into this. Add your salt. Okay. Flour, we are going to add little later. Cream, we are going to add later. Can you see here? This is melting. The butter is like a room temperature. You take butter or you take a cold butter, doesn't matter because you are going to melt it anyways. So, I hope, can you see the pot? Can you see this? Okay, good. Guys, you have to give me a thumbs up. Okay. So we are boiling our water and butter. See, apple pie. Again, we talk about apple pie. So apple pie has a pastry crust. Okay, this is called a double pastry crust pastry. Why? Because you have a bottom, then you put your apple filling, and you cover it from the top again with the pastry dough. So it's a double crust, top and bottom. This is called apple pie.
Chef, there is a query.
Okay.
Which cream are you using?
Okay, so this is heavy cream. See, if you are an Indian, okay, we get Amul cream here. You can use fresh cream, or there is a heavy cream also Amul gives, which is in the red Tetra Pak you get.
Can we take soft butter?
Butter is already here. You are asking that if we can take butter instead of cream?
Can we take soft butter?
Yeah, of course, you're gonna melt it anyways. So the butter is already getting melted.
Is it fine if we use salted butter?
Yes, then see, salted butter is okay because this is savory pastry. What you have to take care about is the amount of salt which you have added. The recipe says 3 grams, you can probably reduce it. See, once the water, you can see there is a boil in it. Okay, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna take it off the heat and add my flour into that. Can you see? Okay, and now I'm gonna mix it. Okay, I'm supposed to do it off the heat. Once the flour is being coated with the water, and then we are gonna start cooking it, okay? And you have to really cook it fast. Okay, this is how this dough is. Once we are done with the cooking, I'll tell you. Okay, you have to be quick. Make sure that it is cooked nicely. There is no dry flour. Okay, you guys are with me with this important process. This is the reason we call it a hot water pastry crust.
Chef, is this the same technique as that of shoe pastry?
Yes, it is. It is. It is. Okay. So you cook it nicely, okay? You see, till the time you see a film of the flour at the bottom, okay?
Chef, there's a query. Won't it split in the water while boiling?
Nothing, there was a butter in it.
Have you used 25% or 35% cream?
No, cream. Cream is 35%. That is the reason I said heavy cream.
And what's the difference between shoe pastry and shortcut pastry?
I'll tell you. Okay, so this is done. Okay, I'm going to take it. Off here. Can you see this? This has left the film. Okay, you can see the thin coating of the flour there. Okay, now I'm going to take a bowl and remove it in this.
Have you already added the cream?
No, I haven't. Okay, what's the question? Well, take it. Mm. See, this is, it is. Now I'm going to just wait for that steam to go off, okay? Okay, so look at this. We are supposed to add our cream a little later. Okay. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna use my blender. Okay, can you see this? I'm just using this to cool it a bit.
Do you have to spread it from there?
Okay. See, basically in this recipe, we add eggs as well, okay? Egg work as a binding agent, okay? This pastry, we have to roll it. It is a crust. So, the egg works better. We are using cream. So, we'll wait for it to cool down a bit. What is the meaning of cool down? It has to, it should not be very hot. And you get the steam. I'm sure you would not be able to see in the camera. But there is some steam which is coming out. This is being hot. Let's get that settled first, okay? We'll wait a couple of minutes more.
Chef, can we use salted butter and skip salt in the recipe?
Yeah, your choice. I think instead of 3 grams, you can use around 1 gram, 1.5 grams. Still be okay. See, there's something called pie and tarts, okay? So, pie could be savory. Indian, we make a atta, we make a dough, we make a rotis. We know a different kind of food to make, okay? But when we talk about Europeans, it is there, one of the comfort food in the earlier times. So what they used to do is they used to make a pie crust and the kind of filling, whatever they can do. It's about the fruit, right? So the apple could be the one fruit, pears could be the another fruit. Initially, the apple pie which was made, it was with the apples, pears, figs, raisins and some spices. Okay, I think it's a bit cool enough. I'll add my cream. See, this cream is working as a, it's giving it a bit moisture, okay? And it is gonna bind my dough together. And at the same time, you can see there was a high butter in this, okay? So this is a very rich pastry dough, you can see.
Chef, how many eggs for that much of cream?
Same amount, 20 grams. So this is my plate. I have taken a parchment paper. You can use cling wrap as well. I'm going to take out this dough in this. Okay. See, you can see how crumbly this dough is. Okay. That's what makes our pastry crust. That's what make our pastry fluffy and crust, the flaky basically. See, so I'm gonna bring it together. Okay, just form a dough with this. I'm not kneading it. I'm just getting it together. Okay. So pastry doughs. When we make tarts, pies is a bigger one. You can make a smaller also. And tarts, which are the smaller ones, with many flavors you can make. So that also has a different pastry. This is one of the pastry base and crust style of doing it, or technique and method of making it. So I'm spreading it a bit. The reason is I'm gonna make the, we have to roll this, okay? So what I'm doing is I'm gonna give it a rectangular shape now, which is gonna make my work later little easy to roll it. Okay, whenever you are supposed to make pastry, whenever you are supposed to make pies and everything, you need a good amount of time. The process is slow, okay? You make a dough, you chill it, you take it out, you roll it, you chill it again to get the best results.
Chef, what is the best replacement of eggs?
See, I have used cream. You can use heavy cream. You have to see, this is a very big term and vast topic. You have to look at the recipes. You have to check the role of the egg in that particular recipe. And accordingly, you have to replace.
Heavy cream is the dairy whipping cream, right?
Yes. Can you see, I have made the kind of a log here, not a log, I have made it rectangle, so it will be easier for me to roll it later. Now I am gonna keep this in chiller, okay? Chiller is like a fridge, chiller is fridge, okay? Not in the freezer. I am gonna keep it there, okay? But you keep it there for a couple of hours, okay? But now we are gonna work faster because we are live here. So I'm gonna keep this in freezer for about 15-20 minutes. Are we together on this? Cool? Okay, so I'm gonna be back, just keeping in the fridge and coming back.
Chef, how long in fridge do we have to keep the dough?
Yeah, please come again.
How long in fridge do we have to keep the dough?
See, the dough has to be settled a bit. So at least a couple of hours. You have to keep it for 1 to 2 hours.
Minimum. If using egg, do we put in both the whites and the yolk?
No, you use an egg yolk. Only the yolk. Okay, so in the meanwhile, our pastry dough is chilling. We are gonna work with our apples. We are gonna work on apple filling, okay? Green apples, we call it green apples in India. They are basically Granny Smith apples. This is what we are going to use for apple filling. Now you will ask me why this apple and why not the normal apples. Okay, the answer is very simple. These apples are very crunchy, hard, okay, and are the red apples sometimes they are very soggy, they are little softer side, these are crunchy. So when we make the filling with the other apples, they tend to get the soggy, earlier, and these stays crunchy, and this is what we use. Now we are going to peel them and cut them.
Can we also use any other filling?
Okay, when we say apple pie and you use other filling, then that's not apple pie, okay? So apple pie, apple filling. Or you want to make any other fruit pie, dessert, like a pear or something, you can do that. Okay, so the queries, whatever you guys, you have query, you can later catch me on Instagram. My Insta handle is hashtag Chobe Labs. It is ChoBeLabs. Chobe Labs, you can catch me there if or with your queries. I would be able to help you after this session. So we're gonna start filling this. Okay, so what happens is when you cut the apples, you know they do get red, right? What I have done here is I have taken a bowl of water and have put the couple of lemon drops in it. I think half teaspoon lemon, which I have put this in this. So this is not gonna get red. I have cut about two apples. I'm gonna cut another one and let's begin. I'm gonna keep this aside. Okay, in the meanwhile, I can handle the queries by the time we peel the apple. It is no rocket science, the same way we do it. So, in the meanwhile, please go ahead.
This can be used for sweet and savory pie. Mm-hmm. Both, right?
Okay, yes.
And in the sweet pie, we have to add the sugar, right?
See, the filling which you are making, okay, that is already going to be sweet. So, choice is yours, you know. You can play with the dessert the way you want. What I am teaching you here is an authentic style of making an apple pie. So, that's the main authentic recipe. Choice is yours, the way you want to modify this.
Please repeat the Insta handle.
It's Chobe Labs. Chobelabs. I'll type it for you so you can catch it there. Okay, it's a normal way of peeling the apples, nothing different.
Can we mix two types of apple in the filling?
Choice is yours completely. See, you should always keep on trying with your recipes. There is no harm. You're going to make a food. Okay, but if you are serving to a client or you're making for somebody, so I would say that stick with the recipes because you want to serve something authentic to your clients, friends or anybody.
When making the pie crust, mm-hmm. you told that we can substitute the cream with eggs, right?
You can.
So why do we only use egg yolk?
So eggs basically. You want to use whole eggs, you can still do that. No problem. Any other query?
Yes.
Please go ahead.
What have I'm we done till now? Can you please repeat it?
Okay. I'm just gonna do that. Okay, I'm gonna show you why these apples, okay? Just see how crunchy they are. Can you hear? So they are crunchy. So that's a good thing about them. That's the reason we use Granny Smith apples. Okay, so the query what we had was,
can you?
Okay, somebody wanted to know the whole process again. Okay, we are gonna do that. So apple pie has a pie crust and apple filling. If you have just joined, I'll tell you we are going ahead with making an apple filling. Recipe is already been shared. Okay. I think I'm gonna take another one. Okay. So what we have made till now is we have made the pastry crust, in which we have used, if you have the recipe, water, flour, all-purpose flour, that is maida, salt, butter and heavy cream, and we have cooked them on the flame on the stove, add the flour, make the pastry dough and have kept it in the fridge. Okay, somebody was asking if we can add the sugar. I would suggest if you are adding the sugar in the pastry dough, please don't cook it. Sugar may get caramelized, may get cooked and may change the color of your dough. So don't cook it. You can make it otherwise, you know, mixing it off the heat. There is something called a semi-texture. You take your flour and butter and start mixing it with the hands. In that you can add sugar. can make that sweet pastry dough as well when we make tarts. So you can make a caramel, there's something called a nutty caramel tarts. Many, when we talk about tarts and pie, lots of variety. Vegetarians, you make with the vegetarian stuff, you can make with the fruits, anything you want to put, it's a kind of stuff.
You can always serve. If we are making the sweet crust, so what is the quantity of sugar we need to add?
Okay, this is difficult to answer right now because the recipe will change completely, okay? Then the water will also reduce because here we have cooked it. The water has evaporated, has been binded with the flour. Okay, that recipe would be different.
Can maida be replaced by wheat?
No, you cannot. See, there are certain recipes. You cannot change and modify the complete recipes.
What is the role of heavy cream in a short crust?
It's a binding. See, I said that we have replaced it for eggs. So it basically gives a little moisture and binding to the dough. It binds the dough together and gives the richness of it. Okay. So this is being done. Shaina, thank you. Keep it aside. Okay. So I'm going to cut this apples. You will see in the bowl that they are in the cubes. Can you see that? We are not going to cut it very fine. We are going to keep it in the cube itself. The reason is we don't want it soggy. We don't want it like a paste. Okay, I'm going to keep them in the cubes itself.
What is the difference between a tart and a pie?
So pies are supposed to be savory, tarts are sweet, desserts. When you want to make something, not dessert, not sweet, pies, you can have any kind of a vegetable filling or a meat or non-veg stuff, whatever you wish.
Chef, there's a query. Is heavy cream and fresh cream the same?
No, they are not. Fresh cream, what we get from Amul, is about 20% of the fats, and heavy cream which we use is 35% fat into it, which gets whipped. Heavy cream you can whip it, fresh cream you cannot whip. See, I'm keeping it in the cubes itself. I am not making them very short because I don't want them to get soggy. However, what I can see is it's been discolored a bit because I did it about an hour back. Let's cut them more. Looks good. I think I forgot to introduce myself in the beginning. My name is Ritu Mishra. I have been studying with Academy of Pastry Arts, the EPCA, on the Instagram where I am live right now. Okay, I have been pursuing my advanced diploma course with them. There are a few good recipes which you can find on my YouTube channel. Yes, I have a YouTube channel which is again the same. I'll type it for you. It's Chobi Labs, ChoBelabs. Do subscribe to my channel. Follow me there. You will have some simple, easy dessert recipes. I try to put about 100 recipes every week. Okay, we are almost done here. And now we are going to cook our apple filling. And before this, before we start cooking our apple filling, I have kept the dough in the freezer. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna roll a bit so it would be ready for us to line the pie later. Okay, this is our apple. Looks good. They are crunchy, let me tell you that. Okay. Give me a minute. I'll get my pastry dough. This is my pastry dough. We keep it in the fridge, not freezer, okay? But right now I have kept it in the freezer. Now I'm gonna roll it a bit. I'm gonna take another piece of parchment paper. Let me get that. Paper, I'll tell you why. See, this is how the dough looks. Can you see this? Okay, I'm gonna put this. Don't pick it up, okay? This is soft. You cannot pick this up. I'm gonna roll this. The thickness, what you need is 2.5 to 3 mm, okay? I'll show you over the scale. So you have 1 centimeter. And when we say 3 mm, make it 3 mm. Generally, we keep it 2.5 mm. But I'm gonna keep this 3 mm because this is a pie. Apple filling is heavy to hold it. Okay, I'm just gonna roll it a bit. Okay, do it with a light hand and make sure that you have applying the equal pressure everywhere so it get rolled up nicely. Yes, please tell me.
Chef, will this video be saved?
I'll save this in the stories or it will be available in highlights for a couple of days, I think so. I'll try to save the copy of this on my IGTV as well. Okay, I'm gonna roll it a bit thinner. Are you guys with me on this? You wanna see this? Look at this. But this is thick. I'm gonna make it thinner. Okay? Just flip it once. Remove it. Keep it again.
Of the crust.
Okay, so she's my daughter, she's also enjoying being live. Okay, the thickness of the crust is 3 mm. I just explained to you 1 centimeter is about 10 mm. We are gonna keep it 3 mm, okay? Okay, you plan yourself, you make a dough, keep it in the fridge for a couple of hours, take it out, roll it, keep it in the fridge. I mean, it's a process, okay? So we are working faster so we can finish this recipe. Okay, look at this, looks good. I'm gonna transfer this again on my tray. And I'm gonna keep it in the, you're supposed to keep this again in the fridge for 1 hour. I'm gonna keep it in the freezer right now. But please make a note of keeping it in the fridge. I'll be back. Guys, so I've kept it again. Now we are gonna make our apple filling, okay? So let's sieve our apples first. Let's take it out from the water. I'm gonna just take it out from the water.
When we are keeping the dough in the fridge, how long do we have to keep it for?
Again for 1 hour. Okay, I'm not going to use the whole apples because they are more than my recipe. I'm going to avoid around one apple of it. Okay. Okay, I'll just keep this aside. Our apples are here. Okay guys, recipe do you have in front of you? Okay, recipe, we need some butter, breadcrumbs, cinnamon powder, some sugar and raisins, and yes, vanilla essence. Okay, it's an extract. Can you see the pan, guys? Thumbs up, please. Okay. I'm gonna heat this. Okay, I am gonna add my butter, sugar, apples, and cinnamon. So what I'm not adding is my raisins right now. I'll tell you as we bake, okay? As we cook along. Okay, I have my raisins here. This is breadcrumbs. I'm going to tell you why the breadcrumbs. Yes, please.
Chef, what is the brand of the vanilla extract that you are using?
Okay, I'll show you. It's natural bonbon vanilla. See, if you want to, you know, go for... little less expensive options, you can go for vanilla essence and other stuff. If you're cooking for your loved ones, for yourself, and if you want to, you know, be a little extravagant to spend things, you can go for vanilla extract. Use that. It does taste good. This is cinnamon powder. Okay. A little amount of butter. I'm waiting for my pan to get hot. I'll tell you why. So we are gonna cook this all together. What I'm doing is, I'm gonna put my sugar into this on my apples. butter again I'm adding here. I can put it in the pan also. Let me put it here, no problem. Cinnamon here. Okay. And these things I'm gonna add in my pan. So what happens is when we cook our apples, okay, apple will start releasing its water. Please pay attention. When we are gonna cook our apple, okay, when we are gonna cook our apples, they are gonna release their water, and we have to make sure that the whole water gets evaporated. At the same time, the apples are getting cooked. Okay, so I'm waiting for my pan to get hot enough that I can put my apple into that.
Chef, are you using regular sugar, caster sugar or powdered sugar?
I'm using caster sugar. Why? I'll tell you the reason. Caster sugar gets melted fast, okay, and it's a more pure form of sugar than the granulated sugar which we normally use at our home. You know, it has some dust particles. You will see that when you make a chashni or something, sugar syrup, there is always a black dots over that, okay. So caster sugar is something which helps, which is more clear, which gets melted fast. Okay, the pan is good, it is hot. I'm gonna add my apples. Can you hear the noise? Okay, can you hear the noise? The reason why? Because the water will start evaporating faster. The apple is gonna release its water itself, and we have to cook this. Okay, the cooking is gonna take time. In the meanwhile, we can talk. We can chit chat. Anything you wanna share, anything you wanna talk, please go ahead.
Chef, can you please repeat what you put in this mixture?
Yeah, sure. There is some butter, apples, sugar, and cinnamon. We have our raisins which we are gonna add later. Okay, I'll tell you now. Not later now, okay? Raisins we will add later, because whatever the water, the moisture it has, again the raisins are gonna soak the water. Aapko pata hai, paani mein dalne ke baad mein phul jaate hain, theek hai? So this is again gonna soak the water moisture. The same reason we don't want our apple filling to be very soggy. We are gonna add breadcrumbs in the end, so it will, you know, soak the complete moisture from the apple pie, from the apple filling, and when we put it and transfer it on the pie, it's gonna be not soggy. It's not gonna, you know, soften our base, and gonna be there later. Okay, so we are cooking it. Meanwhile, we can talk.
Chef, what is the substitute of sugar?
Seriously, I don't want to answer that. It's your choice. Add honey, add jaggery, whatever you want. Okay, we are cooking it. See, this is the reason we have kept it in the chunks. Can you see that? You have all the time. It's gonna take time. You can get the the flavor, the cinnamon. Oh my god, this is really the fragrance is good. Cinnamon really adds to the flavor. Come to my academy. People who want to study bakery, please come to my academy. Academy of Pastry Arts. It's really good the way we learn in the academy, in the school. The reason is, you know the actual reasons and science and technicalities behind baking, okay? So there are many things. I'm really glad that I have started learning things.
Chef, can you substitute bread crumbs with biscuit crumbs or cake crumbs?
Not the biscuit crumbs, but cake crumbs, yes, you can do that. What a vanilla sponge cake. Wow, it's gonna taste better. Let me tell you that.
Can this be made diabetic friendly too using sugar free or stevia or anything else?
Yes, of course. Because stevia is highly sugared, okay? Stevia is about 50 times. When you know about it, you know how much you have to put. You can certainly do that. And apple, the you know, the fruits have their own sweetness. You can work with that. See, anything you substitute or you change in the recipe, it will have a direct effect on the texture and the product and the taste, which you have to bear in mind. You can do that.
If we are using another fruit to make this pie, do we have to do the same process?
No, the taste, the process, process is about cooking that particular fruit, depends. See, if you use pear, okay, the pears are generally not so crunchy like apple. Cinnamon goes with apple. With pear, you need to see which spice or something which you like. Okay, and pears are basically a sweet tart, a fruit tart, which goes very well with the almond cream. For that, you have to make an almond cream, which you make a pie tart, you put an almond cream, you apply your pear slices over it. And they are open tarts basically, they are not covered.
What brand heavy cream is used?
I have used Amul. Currently heavy Amul cream. I can show you the red packet if you want. Get that, Shaina, please get that box. Thank you. Can you see this? Water is evaporating. Now we have less of moisture. Is it visible? Can you see the pot clearly? Thumbs up? Okay. See? At the same time, I'm gonna lower the flame right now. The reason is the water will get evaporated and I want my apples to be cooked a bit, not too much.
At which temperature do we have to cook the apples and how much time?
The apple, you have to cook it on a medium flame. Don't cook it on a high flame. I did that in the beginning when I wanted to heat my pan. Okay, the reason is you don't want apple to get cooked very fast. Okay, you want that flavors which you have put into this, the apple to absorb that flavor. Okay, so you have to cook it. That's the reason I have lowered the flame right now. Okay, so I'm not gonna cook it too much. The reason is when we are gonna bake our pie, they are gonna be cooked further in the oven for another 45 to 50 minutes.
Can we use corn flour instead of breadcrumbs or crumbs?
I personally don't like flavor of corn flour. I would not suggest. How will you? I mean, corn flour will not taste good. Don't go for it. The vanilla cake crumb is a good idea. Go for that.
Are you based in UP?
Why do you say so? Because of my name? No, I'm in Mumbai. My academy is based in Mumbai. Academy is in Bangalore and Gurgaon as well. Okay, can you see it has the moisture is gone? This is the time I'm gonna add my raisins. Okay, I'm gonna cook them together with that.
There's a query that do we have to cook 50% apple in pan?
Yes. The reason is I just told you that they are gonna get further cooked in the oven. When you're gonna bake your pie, the apple is also gonna get cooked, right? Are you there with me on this? The pastry base is gonna get cooked. The pastry filling, the pie filling is gonna get cooked. See, there's already, we have evaporated all the moisture from this. Okay, now the best ingredient we are gonna add is our vanilla.
Chef, it's difficult to buy this heavy cream and not easily available. Yep. So, can we use something else?
Okay. Milk, you can use milk. Yes. No problem. Use milk. this is what the Amul has. The blue Tetra Pak which you get is called fresh cream. This is called Amul whipped cream which you can whip. But you have to make sure it has to be very, very chilled for it to whip it. Apple looks good. Okay. So we have cooked them enough. Okay. The moisture has evaporated. So I am not gonna add my all the breadcrumbs. Okay. I'm gonna add a little bit. And let's see how does it look. See, it completely depends. Okay. We follow the recipe, but at the same time, you have to see what is happening in your pan. You cannot just ignore it. Okay. So when making a dough, you use the salted butter. You reduce the salt. When making an apple pie, see, I think I'm not going to use more crumbs. I'm not going to use it. This is dry enough. This looks good. We are going to stop it here. And this smells also good. I'm going to switch it off. Okay. Just give me a minute. Let me keep it aside and come back. Have this filling in pass. Can you see? There is no water, there is no moisture, this has dried a bit. That's the reason, that's how we want it, because we are gonna fill this in our pie. And when we are gonna cook it again, the apple is gonna release its moisture. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna transfer this from the different pan, because this is hot and we want this filling to get cooled down a bit before we put it in the pie. Okay, so I'm taking a little wider now, so this can cool fast. Are you guys with me on this? Okay, so let's keep this aside. Let me move this. Okay. I'm just not gonna keep this aside. This looks good. This too. Okay. I'm gonna get my pie dough. Looks good.
Chef, in the apple filling, mm-hmm. What did you put in the last?
Raisins and breadcrumbs. We have put them in the last because we wanted them to soak the moisture off our apple filling. I'll just wash my hands and come. Please give me a minute. Okay guys, this is our pastry base. This is a tart, this is a pie tart which I'm gonna use. Okay, now we have two options. Either I cut one round circle and put into this, or what I can do is cut the strips and put it around. So I'm gonna take a circle one. What I'm gonna do is, okay, keep it like this, and I'm gonna cut a bigger one. Okay guys, shall I start my oven? We have to start preheating it because once we line this up, we are gonna bake it, okay? So let's begin. I have my oven tray. I'm putting my parchment paper here. Let me come back, I'll just start my oven. I'm gonna preheat it at 180 degrees for 10 minutes, 10 good minutes. The oven should be hot enough. Not too hot, we don't want our pastry dough to get melted. I'll explain that, let me start and come again. Okay guys, so this is my tray. I've kept the parchment. Okay. We are gonna line our pie dough here. We have this removable, detachable. Take this out. Okay. And slowly I'm gonna put it there. Okay, so this is the reason you don't keep it in the freezer, okay? You keep it in the fridge. Otherwise, the dough gets baked like this. I have another one. But that's okay, we're gonna stick. Let's see how does we cook with this, okay?
Can we bake the pie in a glass container?
Yes, you can. If it is oven friendly, if it is oven thing, you can certainly. Okay guys, this is when you have to really work fast. I'm sorry about this. Make sure that you line this nicely. Okay, it should go till the corners. I am not removing it from here. I'm gonna keep this like this. Okay, make sure it is touching the corners. Okay, can you see this? Put this in the corners. Okay, this is done. Now we are gonna level this from the center.
Chef, are you going to bake it in a water bath?
No, not at all. So let me just, settle this a bit. Put your fingers and start pressing it from the corner. You don't want the corners to get break, okay? Put it your pastry there. So that's the reason you keep the dough in the fridge. In the freezer it gets very hard, but we had to work, so I had to do that. Okay, settle this a bit. Okay, don't make it too thick, but yes, don't make it too thin. You want a good crunchy pastry, flaky pastry, okay, in which you will put your apple pie, apple filling, not the pie of course. Okay, this looks good. Now what I'm gonna do is transfer this here. Okay. I think the visibility is good. Is it okay now? Can you see this? Good. Keep it in the center. Now I am gonna fill this with the apple filling. Can you see it has been covered from all the corners? Okay. This should have been a little neat job, guys. I agree, but don't keep your dough in the freezer. It has to be in the fridge. So So it's workable. Okay, take your fillings.
Can you please repeat the temperature in which we have to preheat our oven?
180 degrees, 180.
For how much time?
At least 10 minutes or till the time you put it in the cooking. Okay, I'm going to just spread it everywhere.
What is the minimum temperature and the maximum temperature?
For what?
For baking.
Minimum as in you cannot bake it on a very low temperature. The pastry will lose its butter and it will become soggy. It will not get crispy. See, I'm going to overfill this. The reason I'm going to tell you again, because apple is again going to lose its moisture. They are going to shrink down a bit and you will see the pastry is going to go down. Okay. So I'm going to put the all filling inside and keep it like a dome.
Chef, do we need to cut the extra dough?
I'll do it. Wait, I'm not cutting it now. I'll tell you the reason why I'm not cutting it now. Okay, so I have made it like a dome. Can you see this? Okay, now I said this is a double pastry crust. One is at the bottom, one is at the top. We are gonna put another latest design over this to make it look good. So we have it here. I'm gonna just use my scale and the cutter. Let's take out some thin strips from this. Is it visible, guys? Can you see this? Cool. So there's this cutter, pizza cutter. You have one which is shaped, which is plate. I'm using the shaped one.
Chef, what is the size of your mold?
Okay, I have scale right there in front of me. It's 5.5 inches or 13-14 centimeters. So take this. I'm gonna keep this here. One is here. Okay, now we need good strips from this side.
In which kind of baking we should use water bath?
Cheesecake. We bake cheesecake in water bath. Okay, the dough is getting softened up. Okay, we have to be careful the way we work. What I'm gonna do is take this here. Okay, I am cutting it from here and gonna put it at the corner. That's the reason I have not cut the dough from the corners. I am gonna attach it with this. Can you see this? And then remove the extra. You can cut it with the hands. Another layer here. Okay, I'm just not fixing it right now. Okay, I have little less. I'll take it from here. And this is here. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna fix the corner ones. Fix it nicely. And this is how the dough has been cut from the extra. Okay. You can use this dough once again, but not again and again, because it loses its the texture what it has. Okay. Now what I'm gonna do is take this. Sorry. You keep it here and you keep it like this. Okay. Just press it with the hands. Okay, let's not put it that way. We are just gonna stick it like that. Because the dough again, we have kept it in the freezer. It has to be in the fridge. Okay. So why decorative? There is a idiom called apple pie order. Okay, what does that mean? That means that you have to do your work neatly the way apple pie is. Okay, you have to put your cupboard neatly. Apple pie order way. The reason is it has to be neat. Okay, so this is what we have done. Now I'm gonna press it on the edges. Okay.
Chef, can you suggest any good brand for OTG and how much liter required for home baking business?
For business, okay. I personally use Morphe digits. Okay, guys, pay attention. Push it at the same time the pastry dough what you have from the bottom. Attach it together. Okay, attach it together. Can you see this? Can you see this, guys? Can you see the dome shape? Okay, I'm just gonna remove this extra pastry from this. This looks good. Dome, the reason is when we will bake this, this is gonna go down. The apple filling which is inside is gonna shrink down, and this the top layers which you can see is also gonna go down. Okay, so attach it nicely, pack it nicely. This looks good. We are gonna egg wash them, but we are making it eggless, so I'm gonna milk wash them. Let me get you that. Okay, for eggless egg wash, the recipe is 30 grams of milk, 20 grams of cream, heavy cream again, but I have taken 15 grams of milk, 10 grams of heavy cream. Okay, add them together.
Chef,
pinch of, tell me.
For tarts, can we use the same pastry dough?
Yeah, if you're making a savory, but if you're making a sweet, you have to make a sweet pastry dough. So guys, a pinch of salt I've already added. Okay, so I'm gonna mix this. Why are we doing the wash? Because we want our pastry to look golden. It should have good color on the top. Okay. Okay, remove this extra thing. You don't want them here. Okay, what temperature we are going to bake this? We are going to bake this at, you can start with 160, 170 for 15-20 minutes and then increase the temperature. Are you getting me on this? The reason is you want the dough and the pastry to get baked nicely. Okay, at 180 degrees it will get colored fast and then you will think that it is already baked. No. So what I'm gonna do is, my oven is getting preheated at 180. I'm gonna bake this at 160 for about 15-20 minutes and then I'm gonna increase my temperature to 180 and bake it for another 20 to 25 minutes. The complete baking time would be about 45 minutes plus. Am I clear on this? Because this has to bake, okay? Okay, lightly brushed this.
Chef, when we increase the temperature to 170 degrees, for how long do we have to bake it?
See, total we are going to bake it for 45 to 50 minutes, okay? And again, it depends. If you have kept couple of it, it might take, please understand, if you have more product on your tray, it is going to take more time. It is single pie right now. It should get done in 45 to 50 minutes. So 170 for 170 or 160, initially 10-20 minutes. And then we are gonna reduce, increase the temperature and bake it again. Can you see? I'm just doing the milk wash, not the egg wash. So this is gonna give us a good color. Looks good. That's end of it. The recipe. Allow me. Okay, if you wanna take a picture, you can probably take a screenshot, other way you want it, guys. I'm just gonna keep this here for a couple of minutes, then I'm gonna ship this to Avan. And
which rod or which rack do you have to keep it?
So you have different functions for your oven, okay, when you bake it at home. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep both the rods on, okay, and the fan is again on. If you have an option, both the rods on and the fan, and I'm gonna put this in the middle rack, okay. So if you guys are done with, you know, clicking the pictures and other stuff, I'm just gonna keep this in the oven. Give me a minute, I'll come back. Okay, I have kept it in the middle rack to bake. I'm just gonna clean my area of working. Okay, we are open with the question answer sessions. In the meanwhile, voila! I mean, my oven works very fast. The pastry is already baked. Do you guys buy this? No. So I have prepared one in the morning so I can show you the final piece. Okay. So my pie is baking. It's gonna take 1 hour. I am gonna send the picture and you can find it on @ayaka_India. You can check it there. See, if you can see, it is basically nice crust, the pastry crust. It is there from the bottom, it is there from the top. At the same time, you will see the filling has been shrinked inside. I should have put more filling into it. But now you will know the reason why we have made that dome. Are we clear on this? Okay, now let's do something about this. Okay, I have some icing sugar here. I'm gonna dust it over this. Wow, I think this is good. Do you wanna eat this? Do you want to cut this? I'll do that, okay? I need a good knife and a plate to cut this. Oh wow. Okay, so this is a plate. I'm gonna serve you guys here. This is hard, okay? But hopefully it should. Wow. Okay, the crust has been baked nicely. Okay, let's cut it. Okay, the slice is out. Whoa! Can you see this? The filling inside has been baked. Your pastry, your apple pie. Apple pies are served with ice cream. You can top it with the whipped cream. You can top it with the whipped cream, you can serve it with the ice cream, you can serve it with the cheese, the way you like it. Thank you. Do you want me to taste this? I can tell you the taste. Okay, let me try this, okay? I should get some reward of putting the effort what I have put in. At the same time, please. This is good. This is good. Let's have some questions if we have, or we are done with this session. Can I remove this part if you want to take a picture? Yeah, please tell me.
Can we bake it on stove instead of oven? If we are baking it on stove, then how many minutes will it take?
Stove, you mean on the gas? In the cooker? Difficult to answer because I haven't really tried that. If you know your skills of doing that, I would suggest if you bake your cake in 25-30 minutes, keep your flame low and 40-45 minutes it should take. See, because this is a crust, can you? I hate to break this, but I'm gonna do this. See, look at the crust, okay? This is a flaky pastry. This is a crust which has to be baked nicely. If you bake it at the higher temperature, it will get burnt, it will not be crispy.
Egg yeah. Wash is with egg white or egg yolk?
Okay, egg wash is again a recipe where you put some one whole egg, two egg yolks, some pinch of salt. I'll share that later.
Can you please repeat the recipe for the milk wash?
30 grams of milk, 20 grams of cream, heavy cream, and pinch of salt.
Yeah. Which rod has, in which rod and rack do we have to bake our pie?
I have put it in the middle rack with both the rods on because you wanted the pastry to get baked from the top and the bottom, and the fan is on because the heat has to bake it.
Chef, how much liter required for home baking business?
See, business, buy the biggest one, whichever you're buying. Always look for the positives.
Can we bake the pie in a microwave convection bake mode?
See, if you're using convection microwave, yes, convection mode, the same way the baking happens, yes, you can bake that.
What is its shelf life?
Okay, now you will see there is no water. The water has been cooked. The apple pie is again pastry. The filling has been cooked. So shelf life, I think it is good to go for another 3-4 days. If you store it nicely, keep it in the fridge. You wanna apple pie can be eaten cold, can be eaten hot. Okay, you wanna eat it hot. You flash it in the microwave, or you know, just flash it about for 3-4 minutes at 160 degree in oven. You keep it in the fridge. You cling wrap this. Keep it in the freezer. So it depends how you keep your product. I think shelf life should be, you can consume it next 3-4 days, 5 days easily.
How can we check if the pie is baked or not?
Look at the color. You have a ready piece here.
Can we store the dough?
Yes, again, the dough has a milk, the butter, water, flour. See, anything which has a water gets spoiled faster. If you cover it nicely, keep it in the freezer. I mean, 3-4 days is good to use. Not more than that, I would not suggest.
How to store baked pie? Should we keep it outside or in the fridge?
Depends. If you're making in the morning, you're consuming it in the evening, please keep it outside. If you're consuming it tomorrow, please keep it in the fridge. If you're consuming after 3-4 days, freezer, please.
What should we do if our oven doesn't have the function of both rods on the bake mode?
Okay, so it depends what functions you have. You have a lower rod function. Keep it at the lower tray, you know, the lower rack for it to bake. Guys, after this session, if you have any queries, you can find me on my Insta handle, which is Chobi Labs, ChobeLabs, Chobi Labs. And I have my YouTube channel, which again goes as www.youtube.com/c/ChobiLabs. You can find some very good recipes there. I would suggest please do subscribe to my channel if you have enjoyed this session. Do we have more queries or we can wind up with the session?
Is this pie baked in a cake tin?
No. Do you want me to show you the ring, which I found was a little bit in the good height? So I have changed the pie tin. I have the ring here only. Just get me the ring. Okay, this is the ring in which I have baked this pie. Can you see this? This is a hollow ring. It's easier to remove the pastry.
Can you please repeat your Instagram ID?
We'll type it here. It is CHOBEELABS. CHOBEELABS. Thank you. I think we have done with the queries. I hope you have enjoyed this session. And happy to have you guys with us here. I think we have just one last query to address.
Can you comment the Instagram ID and the YouTube channel name in the section?
Yeah, I can certainly. We'll do that. You will find this before me end this live session, okay? Thank you so much, guys. Hope to catch you soon. Till then, stay safe and keep baking. Baking is stress buster. Thank you so much.